It is rightly said that a journey of 1,000 miles begins with the most fabulous pair of shoes. And to help you in this journey, we have with us Nupur Chaudhuri.
Thanks, Aishwarya. Hi, everyone.
Hi, Nupur. So tell me something about yourself.
So basically, I am a journalist. I started working as a journalist at the age of 16 with the Indian Express. And I even did my master's in journalism from Australia at the age of 21. But after working for 11 and a half years as a journalist, my last job was deputy editor at Pune Times, Times of India. I needed a break, and I also had this nagging thought of, you know, pursuing my passion for shoes. Like every girl, I am crazy about shoes. But I also went a step further, and I went to London College of Fashion to study footwear design. So that thought was there, you know, you've studied it, do something with it. Yeah. And you've worked 11 years in this job, and life is really short. Mm-hmm. So why not try something new? So to sum me up, like tell you something about myself, I would say I'm a journalist turned footwear designer who is also crazy about animals. I think that sums me up.
Wow. Yeah. So how did the label Nupur Chaudhuri came?
So like I said, I went, you know, I studied footwear design in London. But at that point, I didn't really have the guts to quit my job because, you know, when you have a steady job going, you always wonder how will it be to just, you know, say I'm resigning and start your own business. It's a little daunting. But luckily for me, my then boyfriend, now husband Ashwin, has been like a rock steady support. And he is the one who motivated me to do this because he said, if you don't do it now, 10 years down the line, you will look back and say, why didn't I? So he's like, you don't want to live with regret. So you go after it, launch your own label, see how it goes, take it at your own pace. If it doesn't, you always fall back on writing, which I'm good at, thankfully. So that's when I launched, you know, Nupur. I quit my job and I launched the label. I think it's been about 3 or 4 years now that it's been in existence. And it's been going well. It's sort of been a little hard as well because I was completely new to the field. I have a background of writing. I wrote about designers and I wrote about fashion, but I didn't know what goes into the making of it. Mm-hmm. So, but I've learned along the way, and it's been a pretty nice, interesting journey so far.
That's really nice, yeah, that you followed your dreams.
Yes.
So what inspired you to start this?
So it was that, you know, line that don't live with regret. And also another thing is, at that point when I started, we didn't really get a very interesting variety of shoes. You had, you know, at each shop had very similar kind of footwear. So we would either have to order online, or when you travel abroad, then you get those kind of funky shoes. So that is the, you know, gap that I wanted to bridge with my label. I wanted to add like funk to footwear for women, and it should still be available at a pocket-friendly price. So that is what sort of motivated me to start the label, and that has been the motivation and the underlying factor of the label.
Okay. What motivates you?
Everything. It's like if I see something interesting on TV, or we travel a lot. So when you see interesting architecture, or you see the way people are dressed, that sort of inspires you to, you know, design something. Even if you go to a bar and you see an interesting stool, mm-hmm, it gives you an idea for a heel. It may, yeah, not work out like that, but you know, it inspires you, and then you work on that. So yeah, I look for inspiration everywhere. It could be in a leaf, it could be in a flower. It could just be everywhere. There are no restrictions.
That's so how an artist is born.
Yes.
When you see,
yes,
all the details in, yes, anything possible.
Yes, yes.
How are your designs different from others?
So ours are very contemporary, yet they have this Indian touch in them. It could be either the gold bling that we use, or it could be the design. Like when we started, I gave a twist to Kolhapuris. So we did lovely Kolhapuri wedges, but we also did Kolhapuri gladiators. And we work with heels. So basically I customize our heels as well. So we make different kind of box heels. We'll make cutout heels. Like if I show you this one, We did a lot of trial and error for this box heel because the weight comes on that. So we had to try whether, you know, it is sturdy enough, how it looks, the right placing of the heel, because there should not be too much pressure on the wearer's heel. So that way if you see, it's got something of an Indian touch, like even this edging, yet it is a very contemporary, modern, chic design. So that is what our label is about.
And that is very unique.
Thank you so much.
What is the USP of your label?
So the USP of my label is that our designs reflect me, it's my personality that goes into the designs. And the second most important thing I would say is that we are cruelty-free, 100%. So from our materials to the glue, there are no soles harmed in the making of these soles. Okay. So that is our USP.
That's really inspiring.
Thank you.
What materials do you use?
So, like I said, we're cruelty-free, so we do not touch leather, don't go anywhere next to leather or suede. We use man-made leather, so we use PU, PVC, and we use velvet, we use faux suede. So, it's basically these kind of materials that we use.
Alternatives,
and I also want to get, into the whole eco-friendly part of it. Like, you've heard of mushroom leather coming up. So, eventually, I want to be using that in our designs.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, is Pune ready for designer footwear?
I think Pune was ready the day we started because we got a really good response. It was very heartening to see that people appreciate, the thought, the idea and the work gone into it. Our shoes are completely handmade. So, there's a lot of effort that our karigars put into it. And I think people appreciated that. They appreciated that they're getting something unique to wear. We don't come up with 100, 200 pairs of the same design. Mm-hmm. It'll be 10 pairs in different sizes. So if you pick up a pair in your size, there may just be one other person of that size who's bought it, unless they've given us an order.
Okay.
And that is about our ready collections. And as far as customizing, people love it, especially brides. You know, they want something different that'll stand out.
Yeah.
So we've done where we've matched embroideries to the outfits. But what I always suggest to brides is let your outfit stand out for what it is and let your footwear stand out for what it is. So we work with the color palettes and sometimes we give something completely contrasting. But people are majorly into customizing. Then you have, women with really tiny feet or really large feet. So we do that as well at times, though our main focus is on the ready collection that we come out with.
Okay.
Because again, a lot of our thought and effort has gone into that. So our focus is on promoting that and selling those to customers.
Okay.
Yeah.
What are your designs? How are your designs inspired? What is that one thing that inspires all your footwear designs?
So, like I said, it is, I think it's my personality that goes into it, a little bit of, a little serious, a little naughty, a little, funky. And I would say we have, when we started, we did a lot of gladiators. So it's also inspired by what was in fashion earlier. So we try to get that back. So it sort of has a little retro funk feel to our shoes, and that runs through most of our shoes.
Yeah. And that's what goes on most of the outfits.
It does.
So what have been your biggest strengths and weaknesses?
So my biggest strength, I would say, in my journey is my husband Ashwin, because he's such a big support. He's always motivating me. Even in the business, he assists me in designing because he's very artistic, as well as the business side of it, because I come from a working background, so business is entirely new to me. But Ashwin looks into that and helps me. And there are times when you lose motivation for various things and whatever you do in life. And when that happens to me, he's always there inspiring me and, to just go on. And so I wouldn't be here without him. And other than that, of course, it is my karigars. So if I did not find the right kind of karigars, I would not have reached where I am today. And we just fit very well because they understand what I want and I understand what they need. So it's been a really nice journey with my 8 karigars that I have. And I wouldn't be here either without them. And of course, it is the people, you know, who buy my shoes. Every shoe that I sell is, it motivates me to make more because they appreciate it, they appreciate the effort, they appreciate that we are cruelty-free. And when you see people liking your work, you know that they will be your strength to go on. So that is my biggest strength. And my weakness, I think, sometimes I get lazy. And yeah, like I lose motivation sometimes and I'm like, I don't want to work today. And so that does become a slight weakness in my thing. And suppose we do an exhibition, there are always ups and downs.
Okay.
So some exhibition you will be absolutely sold out. In another exhibition, it would be like, okay, like maybe it wasn't worth doing it. But when that happens, I sort of, it affects me. And that I would say is a weakness, because in business there are ups and downs and you just have to ride it through. So yeah.
Okay. So what challenges did you face while starting this business up?
So when I quit my job, I did not dive into it, you know, without doing another degree. So I went to FDDI Mumbai, which is the Footwear Design and Development Institute. They had a branch in Mumbai, they're based in Noida. And I did a 6-month course with them. So I lived in Bombay, and it was also the 6 months before our wedding, because Ashwin had just proposed. So,
Okay. But
I was away all the while, and I kept coming just on Saturday, Sunday, and then going back Monday early morning. So that was a bit hard for me, planning the wedding and studying, you know, footwear design again, because I did the Bombay course because I wanted to understand the local market, because studying in London and learning how to design is one thing, but bringing that to the table here in India is different. You know, our karigars here are different from the craftsmen over there.
Yeah, that's true.
So that was a little, you know, hard to learn, and surveying the market and finding the right karigars. I went through a huge lot of them before I could actually find them. So it took me an entire year to zero in on these guys and, you know, make tons of samples before we come up with the first collection.
So what are your thoughts on the current fashion trends?
I think the current fashion trends are changing too fast, is what I feel. And that is affecting big fashion houses as well.
Mm.
And it is affecting us as designers, because see, we're too small, so we have to keep up. Compared to a Louis Vuitton or a Salvatore Ferragamo, we are like right there. So you have to keep up with the changing fashion trends, and it's fast fashion that people want nowadays, which you're getting from your Zara, you're getting from Mango, you're getting, you know, from all these stores. So I would say, like, say today, if your pointed toe shoes are in, tomorrow suddenly it's switched to, you know, platforms and platforms.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say the trends change too fast in today's day and age, and to keep up is a bit difficult.
Okay.
Yeah, I would prefer it if slow fashion, you know, was brought back into fashion. Yeah.
So what, according to you, are the biggest blunders that people make while dressing up their feet?
See, I always believe the shoes can make or break an outfit.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you'll see people wearing like such nice figure hugging, you know, beautiful dresses, and then they'll wear really chunky shoes which don't go with it at times. And there are times when, you know, they'll pair baggy stuff with heels. So I think if you have the personality to carry off something that's not that's out of the box, it's fine. But if you don't and you're struggling to, you know, carry, it's like when you wear a short dress and you're constantly pulling it down, it's not right. So it's the same thing with footwear. If you have the confidence to wear a high pair of, you know, heels, wear it. But if you don't, stick to flats and carry that off with confidence.
Yeah. I think people should not try to fit in.
Don't fit
just
in.
Be
just
themselves.
Exactly. Be who you are.
Yeah. So according to you, have the old style of footwear come back to the fashion trends right now?
Absolutely. I feel like everything today is getting inspired from the yesteryears. So even the pointed toes are getting, you know, more pointed. It's like what they used to wear earlier, the 20s or...
Yeah.
So we have those, the kitten heels, the platforms coming back, that whole grunge look.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, definitely inspired by older
the
fashion.
Old, yeah. So what is your personal favorite when it comes to dressing your feet up?
I am an absolute heels person. Like, I love heels. I could run in them, dance in them. I could sleep in, you know, my favorite pair of heels. But lately, we've also recently started a new resto bar, and I work there every evening. So running about there and managing the floor, I have switched to flats. So, but yeah, I enjoy wearing flats, but my favorite is high heels.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what precautions would you suggest to people, you know, to take during monsoons and summer season?
So in summer, it's fine. Like, you know, air your feet out, wear thongs, wear open shoes, sandals, gladiators, and you're good to go. But in monsoons, if there's a puddle and you have to cross it, please hold your shoes up high and walk bare feet, I would say. Don't ruin your shoes. Yeah. Wear rubber, wear monsoon-friendly footwear that's
boots,
out there,
yeah,
in the market.
Boots.
Yeah, yeah.
So the working class needs to know what is trending yet comfortable.
Yeah, so I think now I'm falling into that bracket because I'm working at a restaurant and it's a 6-hour straight shift. Mm-hmm. So I would say wear funky flats, wear flats with, you know, we have flats with gold, white flats with gold fringe on it, which is like our trademark pair. We even showcased a version of that at Lakme Fashion Week last year. So, you know, wear stuff that stands out, yet you can, you know, carry off those 6 hours in it. You're not going to, you know, want to remove the shoes. Mm-hmm. And I would also say comfort-wise, which is what we even studied, a little bit of heel always helps. If you wear absolute flat shoes, your heels are going to hurt.
Yeah.
So if you put in that little bit of, you know, heel, say a 1.5 or 2-inch heel, it's a box heel as well. It's perfect for you to last hours.
And what is your personal brand for footwear?
Nupur Chaudhuri.
Goes without saying.
Yes.
And any plans for expansion?
So, slowly and steadily. We do not have a physical store. So we work by placing our footwear on consignment basis at multi-designer boutiques in Pune and Bombay and Gujarat. So we're looking at expanding to different cities of the country and abroad as well. So we're in talks with a few boutiques. I'm hoping that works out.
Hope that too for you.
Thank you so much.
And where do you see yourself and your brand in the next 5 years?
So, in the next 5 years, I hope, you know, people not only in Pune and Bombay know Nupur Chaudhuri. I hope that people across the country want and wear my label. So, and maybe in the next 10 years, I would say I'd like my own boutique with, preferably maybe we could have a tiny little boutique attached to Mr. Rabbit's. Who knows? So, yeah, that's what my plan is as of now.
And since the designs are so beautiful and so unique. So thank you, Nupur. It was lovely having you on Ornate Pune.
Thank you so much.
And
it was lovely.
All you crazy people for fashion, please come, and y'all know where y'all have to come because Nupur Chaudhuri is the future.
Yes, listen to her.
Thank you.
Thank you.